Scuba Scoop is sponsored by
Get Nana Habo Mouthwash and your problems will be no more.
It's a Tuesday. I know usually the Mondays we always run through what's happening or what happened during the weekend, but yesterday I had just too much juice was going about. I couldn't help myself but give you juice yesterday. So today, it being a Tuesday, I'd like to officially welcome you to another gossip filled week. My name is Tina Fierce-Wern, and this episode was proudly sponsored by none other than Nana Habo Mouthwash. Go get the product, try the product. It is a beautiful product. Welcome to Scoop and Scoop. Okay, we're still trying to authenticate the whole Chameleon and Daniela split situation, because he's not in the country. Of course, you can never always reach out to Daniela for anything. She's always like, I have no comment. Okay, cool. I haven't called her because I feel there's no need for me to call her and put her through that in case it is probably a leakage or whatever. But as we are still trying to get that together, I read somewhere, I hear apparently Chameleon's account could have been hacked. Hacked? But then, Saba, abantu abaliyeyo. Like, you have your artists. I do get it. Now, I know it is hard to manage a Ugandan artist. Them is all weird. They're weird like that. I know it's hard to maintain them. I know it's hard to market them. And I know what's even harder is you as a manager, as a manager, I feel like it is so hard for Ugandan managers to fathom the thought that they actually need a PR too on their team, because this is just dumb. Ongambo Tiambo, again, the account was hacked. They did that again last year, around the same time. It could have been not the same time, but it was around the same time that he had legend hit after hit. Now, here we go, a year down the road, and the same ish is repeating itself. And you want us to believe that it could be a hack. Okay, it could be a hack. Let's just say it could be a hack. Nanga hacker wo ali lazy. You know, at least the person who hacked Zari's account was fun. You know, they gave us throwback photos of Diamond Platinums and her Hamisa. Like, they mangled up our brains. We were so confused. How come your hacker is so lazy that every year they show up just to say, these guys are breaking up again? Like, what does your hacker have against you and Daniela's marriage? Like, Chichi, and you probably is. Because if you caught the last one, then I would expect the second one to be a totally different one who'd come up with a different playbook. But clearly, there is no different playbook. It is still the same script, just a different day. Come on, Namwa Mutubaremo. I mean, like, I'm honestly considering it. I am deeply rooted in my mind. I'm like, you know what, Tina? You can't just be a musical critic. You can't just be a gossip person. You can't just be a critique. I think I'm going to head into PR, because I look at half of all the artists here. Has someone ever pissed you off so hard you come down on the inside because you're that mad? That is what Ugandan artists do to me. But apparently the account could be hacked. Whoever is believing that, believe that is shy, eh? I'm not going to be among the stupid ones. How? Maybe at times my opinion is what's bothering me. But I read somewhere, I think it was on Ykee's page, one of his social media pages, and he was like, yo, he's ready to do a musical battle, you know, give him people from who have been in the industry from 4 years back. Like, he feels he's at that point in his life where he is winning. He's about to call himself the greatest of all time, GOAT. In my mind, I'm like, meh, God. But anyway, he put that out, and I sat down and I'm like, meh, church waga waiki. That's what I wanted to ask myself. Yes, you have a couple of songs. They're doing really well. They're in heavy rotation. The masses seem to like you, only that we like you in small doses, because at times you come off a little bit too extra. So I'm like, is he trying to throw subtle shade? Yes, because that's subtle shade. Is he trying to throw subtle shade to all the artists who have been around for the past 4 years and haven't achieved anything that he has achieved? And I looked back, I'm like, wait, achieved what? What has Ykee Benda achieved? Doing the Coca-Cola World Cup song, which is not officially on. When you're YouTube, you have to first go through like 4 different versions. Kakati tusoke tudeo kubantuwa ya wadebu zako 4 years ago. Who has been here for the past 4 years? Sheba's been around. She's done Coke Studio. She's been on different stages. She's been winning. Would you see a battle going down between Shiba and Ykee Benda? Because that's the thing. The thing about Ykee Benda is that the only person I feel I can pit you against is Apus. Because according to me, you, Apus, that stupid boy, Latinam. You know, Apus, Ykee Benda, Latinam. Who else? There's supposed to be like four. Those four are almost in the same category. So if you were looking for a battle, I don't think you should have just gone like Mobalete. No, you know who you're up against. You know who you're up against. Don't stand up and say, Apus, I want to battle you. And we all know, well, Apus is so many things that are annoying most of the times. But you have to honestly give it up to his ingenious mind. He can write. He can. I'm not so sure if Ykee Benda writes all his music. Does he? Bagulangule, as a singer. Then they modify it to him. This industry is such a joke. Like, you see someone who hasn't barely gotten a place. Now, this is not me trying to steal your light, Ykee. To be honest, I feel you have done your thing, and it's a good thing. The masses are loving you. I mean, I dance to some of your music, but I think it's way too early for you to start getting cocky. And on top of that, man, twako webi into via battle. Do you know what it means? Edda, nga Bobby Wine. And then you go for that chivuru. Bobby Wine na kugamba, aine nyimba, he would say, I have 3,000 songs. Bebe Kul would also say, I have 5,000. Aya tutuke. And you listen to music that doesn't make sense. Chivuru chidambo mazosa sula sente zonga zikulumye. And you'd still never know. Anya sins. So, the industry has grown, Boothang. You don't even have to call out for the competition. Let your work speak for you. That's what I want to tell people. Like, Yomi is out here showing and telling. Murekera wokwogera. Stop talking. You have to be able to talk the talk and walk the walk. Period. If he had posted this, ngamoze ready achari mulamu. Biandi womye. Oh, ready ya fanya. Like, some of the things I'm seeing in the industry right now. Every time I see something dumb, the first thing that goes to my mind is like, what would have radio said about this? I miss that guy. I really, really miss that guy. Like, I felt we lost the only person who would say what he had to say, when he had to say it, how he wanted to say it, and you'd get the message, and he would never mince his words. Which is different, because everyone used to think that radio was a loose cannon, that his mouth would just go for a yes, it used to. But what was going out of his mouth, you know? Aganaga, man, when Aganaga came out, I don't know about all his other songs, but me, that Ndabidawa song, it took me, you could have sold me to that song and I would still love it. It was a beautiful, breathtaking song. I thought he had a very long career ahead of him. He signed to Emma Carlos, and then all of a sudden it just went zip, nothing. And then, as we're still used, because you know Uganda, we have a lot to deal with. As we were still thinking of the next person to put up there, because now we're done with Vinka, who is our new artist. Vinka is not new anymore. Anyway, that's besides the point. As I'm still getting used to the fact that he's non-existent on the musical scene, someone goes and they break it. They like break it to me. I'm like, wait, that's like the smartest thing I've seen anybody in this industry do. This is what happened. So Aganaga was signed to Emma Carlos. His contract was a little bit too low. Midway into the contract, he felt he was not partaking on the terms of a contract, like it wasn't working for him. And he couldn't get out of the contract because that's a whole libel issue. It becomes this and that. A lot of money would have been lost. So do you know what this genius did, like the Americans, like what Lil Wayne did? When he decided not to do any new music until he's out of the contract, that's what he exactly did. He shut up. Emma Carlos couldn't get jack for him. He couldn't write songs. He wasn't recording none. He was nothing. And then the contract ended, and voila, Aganaga is back. He has this new massive song with Chameleon. I was like, oh my word, this may be the only sensible artist left at the moment who is thinking about his money, not just the fame. He's thinking about his money. He is securing the bag. You know what? Big up to you, Aganaga. It's a risky move, but hey, closed mouths, they don't get fed on this boulevard. So good for him. I'm glad he figured that one out. Anyway, I guess it's one of those days where I just felt like I needed to rant. It's been a minute. It's Petty Tuesdays. And I'm Tina Fierce One. On Twitter, you can get me at Tina Fierce One. On Facebook, it's at Tina Fierce One. And of course, that is Scoop and Scoop 2. Like and follow the pages. On Instagram, it's at Tina Fierce One with an H. I'm out. Catch you again tomorrow. Peace. We'll be right back.
Scoop and Scoop was sponsored by
Get Nana Herbal Mouthwash and your problems will be no more.